Today's video is on coriander oils and essential oils. Yes. Now, I get a lot of questions actually, and some people don't even know anything about essential oils. Yeah, to be honest with you, like, there are people that don't even know about essential oils. Well, there are some that know essential oils, but they don't even really know what essential oils are all about. A lot of people confuse essential oils for coriander oils. And guess what? Let me shock you. Essential oils are not really, really oils. Like, they are not oily. Do you understand? And they are volatile in nature. What I mean by they are volatile in nature is the fact that they have the tendency to, like, kind of evaporate. Yeah, like mentholated spirit. You know how mentholated spirit could actually evaporate. So essential oil has that same tendency. You understand? But coriander oils are not that way. Coriander oils mostly are like vegetable oils. Yes, they are example of such oils are like the olive oil, the sunflower oil, the coconut oil. All those are coriander oils.
Strong Case, the jam maker.
Back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, my name is Asmau, Zakari, and please do well to hit the subscription bell button. It's free. All right. Okay. Today is all about essential oils and coriander oils, as you could see from the topic of today's video. First and foremost, essential oils are not really, really oils. Yes. They are volatile in nature, that is, they have the tendency to evaporate. You understand that it can easily oxidize, you understand? But the coriander oils are the real oils. Now, to be honest with you, essential oils will function better when diluted with coriander oils. Yes. Okay, when I tell you that essential oils are not really, really oils, I'm just trying to tell you that they're gotten from a very potent part of this plant, because I hope you know essential oils are botanical extracts, just the same way coriander oils as well. They are all botanical, like more like they are all plant extracts. Both the essential oils and the coriander oils are all gotten from plants, but this is it. The essential oils is gotten from the most potent, like the most active, and that is why all the time when you hear people talk about essential oils, they always tell you about patch test, make sure it's compatible to your skin, you know. And some people will even make essential oils sound like acid, like, you know, like something that's going to burn you if you don't take care. Yeah, to some extent, depending on your skin type, there are people that have really, really sensitive skin, so essential oils could actually be detrimental. Like, I wouldn't use the word, maybe that's too exaggerated. Like, it's kind of it can be too harsh on the skin. Do you understand? So essential oils go well with the coriander oils. And then let me tell you something quickly again about the essential oils. Essential oils have a longer lifespan. Yes. Yeah. You surprised? It has a longer lifespan than the coriander oils. And as I said earlier, it's volatile. So what does it mean that it's volatile? That is why you see most essential oils, they come in a dark bottle. Yes, in a dark bottle container, in order to preserve it, you know, to make, not to allow it to, like, go haywire, like, not to oxidize, you know what I mean. Okay, and coriander oils now are mostly vegetable oils, as I said, mostly. They are not compatible with water. Yes, meanwhile, essential oils are actually compatible with water, but coriander oils are not compatible with water. And coriander oils do not have the long lifespan that essential oils have. Yes, coriander oils are very, very effective in all ways. Like, they can work on the skin, for hair and other things. So also the essential oils, they are also good for your hair, for your skin, and even for health purposes in some cases. Okay, the essential oils functions better when it has a coriander oil. Yes, the coriander oil, most of them contain fatty acids, fatty lipids as well, and they are very, very good to neutralize the essential oil. Whatever skin type you have, to be honest with you, I recommend the mixing of essential oils. I am not on the part of using essential oils directly. Yes. Okay, and also essential oils, depending on the brand they belong, some brands have highly concentrated essential oils, like very, very, really, really highly concentrated essential oils. Do you understand why some brands, their essential oils are not so high, they're just medium, why some they are low? So just as I always say, study your ingredients, study your essential oils, know where essential oil stands. Does the essential oil stand the category of where it's highly potent, or where it's medium potent, or where it's low potent? So depending on where your essential oils belongs, that is how it's going to be diluted with your courier oils. Let me give you a quick example. Example, you want to dilute 1 teaspoon of tea tree oil. Tea tree oil is an essential oil. Example, you want to dilute 1 teaspoon of tea tree oil. At least you'll be able to dilute it with about 3 teaspoons of maybe olive oil. Yes, so what I'm trying to say is, depending on the concentration, let's say the essential oil and the tea tree essential oil belong to a high concentration, you're diluting 1 teaspoon, you're going to dilute with 5 teaspoons. I don't know if I'm clear here, but if it's on medium level, you can dilute 1 teaspoon to like 3 teaspoons. If it's on a very low level, then you could do it like maybe 50-50. You understand? So knowing the concentration of your essential oil is very key before you dilute it in your courier oils. Courier oils, of course, they are very, very safe. You don't need a patch test. But then one very quick thing, as I said earlier, courier oils don't go well with water. Yes, it doesn't really go well with water. And courier oils are heavy, while essential oils are greasy, they're lighter. So technically, there's a huge difference between essential oils and courier oils. Courier oils are the diluting oils for essential oils. There is hardly a definition of essential oils without courier oils. So let me add something again very quickly. So people will tell you about infusion. You understand? Infusion oils are not essential oils. Yes, example of such infusion oils are like the avocado oils, the jojoba oils, yes, the neem seed oil. In fact, it's most, in some cases, even the carrot oil, yeah, is not an essential oil. It also falls in the category of courier oils. They are just more of infusional oils. And they are being infused mostly with courier oils. So to be honest with you, infusion oils are not essential oils. They still fall in the category of courier oils. So please do well to subscribe to my YouTube channel, drop your comments in the comment section, and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. And thank you so much for coming, returning subscribers. You know that you guys are the real MVP. I love you guys always. New subscribers, welcome. Thank you for joining the family, and see you in another video. Bye. Thank you.